guys, it's Gretchen, and welcome back to my channel.
It is time for another fix.
Today's video is my October Stitch Fix try-on. I don't know why I continue to call it an unboxing because I already unboxed it before I get on a camera, but we're just gonna continue with it. So yes, it is time for October Stitch Fix. This month, I completely forgot to put a note to my stylist of things I wanted. Oops. I just got super busy and I was like, oh, I'll do that later tonight. Later tonight came and went for like an entire week and I just completely forgot in general until I went onto the app to do like the little rating system and it was like, your stylist is styling your box. And I'm like, oh. So this month, everything was kind of like whatever my stylist thought I would like, which I don't mind doing boxes like that because it's interesting to see what a stylist will send you if you don't give them any kind of guidance. I wasn't mad about the fact that I missed out on it. I knew Blake Lindsay would not steer me wrong. So for this month, Blake Lindsay sent me 3 tops, a pair of pants, and jewelry, which was really exciting. I haven't gotten jewelry from Stitch Fix in a long time. I did take off that I don't want earrings. Obviously, Stitch Fix doesn't cater to stretched lobes or anything like that, so there's really no sense in me saying, send me earrings that I can't wear. So they can send me bracelets and necklaces. This one was a necklace. I will say I am probably gonna end up keeping all 5 items, even though there is at least one in this box where I'm just kind of like, meh. As I've said in the past, if there's only one item in the box where I'm feeling a little iffy on, I usually end up buying the whole box because it ends up being cheaper in the long run because of the discount of if you buy 5 items, you get 25% off. So yeah, I'll save that item for last. I'll show you the items that I really like first, and then I'll show you the kind of meh one at the end. So I think I'll go in order of what I like the most to what I like the least. So the item that I love the most in this fix was by Love Always, and it is the Mia Back Detail Pullover. So this is a green sweater. Now in the picture that you get with your Stitch Fix, or in the picture if you go on the app to look at the items that you have gotten for that fix, it looks a whole lot more bulkier than it actually is. Like, I was expecting a bulky sweater like this, but this is actually a pretty form-fitting sweater. Not like hugs your curves, but definitely not a floppy sweater like this one is. This one, a little bit thinner material than I was expecting, but I do love this green. Didn't I get something like this last month or something similar in this color? I don't remember, but that's fine. I like the color. It's a very nice fallish, winterish color. This is gonna be great at Christmas time. I love sweaters like this because of the back detail. It's kind of hard to see on camera, I know, but this little back detailing, I absolutely love things like that. This sweater that I'm currently wearing has the same kind of crosshatch detail. I love that. This one is more appropriate for work because if I wear like, I don't know, a camisole or something underneath, perfectly fine. It's also a little bit more form-fitting, so it's not falling off my shoulders like this one is. I really like this. It is long sleeve, so it goes all the way to the wrist. The bottom part is all the same length. It does have a little bit of a stretch down at the bottom. Actually, the whole thing is pretty stretchy. Very soft. This is a size small in dark green. Retails for $44, so honestly, for a sweater, you can't beat that. And I really love this one. I love the color. I love the shade of green. It reminds me so much of wintertime, you know, Christmas with the trees and everything like that. I absolutely love this. So this is probably my favorite item in the entire box. I will probably live in this quite a bit this fall and winter. The next item that I really love in this box is by Mix by 41 Hawthorn, which is interesting because usually I just get 41 Hawthorn, but apparently this is like their side company? I don't know. Mix by 41 Hawthorn, I don't know. But it is this Paulsen brushed knit top. It's in the color mustard, size small, and retails for $38. Now, it's just a very simple pullover, but there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, I feel like this box was kind of half comfy, half worky, if that makes any kind of sense. But I love it. I love this mustard color. I like the kind of like the gray mixing of it. Maybe that's why it's called Mixed by 41 Hawthorn, I don't know. This one is not quite 3/4 length sleeve, but it doesn't go to your wrist all the way, as you can kind of see against the bottom part of the sweater. It's very cozy, very comfy, a good lounge around the house or just go out and do errands type of top. I just really like it. I love the gray mixed into it. I feel like yellow and gray are such a good color combination anyway. I would definitely wear this, wear some black leggings, and just lounge around the house and clean or go to the store with this on. It's an awesome top. I love this tremendously, and I also feel like you could dress it up for work. It's a really good universal top. I like it a lot. Very good for fall, maybe even winter, but it is a good comfy cozy sweater. The next item in the box is actually the jewelry item they sent me, and there is no try on video for it because I'm trying it on right now. It is this necklace that I currently have on by Jill Michael. It is the Elliot pre-layered bar necklace. I have wanted a necklace like this for a long time. This is the kind of thing that I'll either wear out on a nice date or even to work or something like that. Usually if I'm like lounging around or if I'm just running errands or something, I'll wear like my choker necklaces or what have you. But I have wanted a layered necklace like this for quite some time. So I'm really excited that Blake Lindsay sent this to me. It retails for $28, which honestly is not bad. That may sound expensive, but if you go to Target, you can find necklaces similar, like a little bit cheaper, but I feel like this might be better quality than what you might find at Target. Sorry, Target, love you dearly, but just being honest. I just really like the look of this. It's one of those necklaces where you can make it longer, you can make it shorter. I do think this is the shortest that it can get because I do have it on the shortest like little chain in the back, but if I make it longer it could come to like here. I like that about those types of necklaces, that you can adjust the length. I will say I spent almost 30 minutes untangling this necklace though when it came out of its box. This was the box that it came in, and you could tell that it was just like placed in here. Stitch Fix, y'all have got to do better about sending or shipping your jewelry, because that was a nightmare. I almost sent it back to you all just because I didn't want to deal with it any longer, but luckily I was able to get it untangled, but that was a nightmare. That's the only downside to it, but I love the layered look. And as you can see, the bar can move, so you gotta be a little aware of that in case you don't want it to be moving too much, if you want it to stay in the middle like this. But I love how it looks, so I was really excited that she sent this to me. The next item on my list is the pair of pants that I was sent. This is by Liverpool. These are the Jacqueline skinny pants. They're solid black. These are size 2s or waist 26. They're very comfortable. They feel like super tight leggings, but they're pants. They do have some stretch to them. They are skinny at the bottom. They have pockets. Oh, wow, I'm dumb. The tag says leggings, but they are pants. Well, that would explain why they feel like leggings. But the pants, so best of both worlds. I mean, you know, they're just regular black pants. Can't really say too much about them. They fit like a glove, like leggings do. And I do like the little bit of stretch to them. Even the waist has some stretch to them. Not a whole lot, but their stretch. I really like them. I felt good in these. They felt good on me. Black pants for the win. I have like 5 pair, but you can never have enough black pants or jeans, honestly, in my opinion. And those pants retail for $78. Some people may think that's expensive, but you know, for a good quality pair of pants, I think it's fine. Even though they are have a tag on them that says leggings, they're still pants. And the final item, which is the one that I'm kind of like meh about, is by Lay Liz. I have quite a few items from Lay Liz. It is this Alante woven back knit top. I love the front. It's this really pretty purple. It is 3/4 length sleeve. I love this purple. It has a little bit of a V-neck going on. I like that too. The part that I'm kind of like meh about is the back part. On the back, it has this different kind of fabric back here with a bunch of floral patterns on it. I am not a big floral person. I'll wear floral. Like if I find a specific item that has floral on it and I love it, I will wear it. Not exactly a fan of this floral too much, but again, I like the other 4 items so much that it's just cheaper for me in the long run to buy all 5 items, learn to love this one, or even give it away. But maybe it'll grow on me, I don't know. As you can see, and as you'll tell in the try-on video, back part does dip down a little bit further than the front part. I really like the front part. I will say it's a little bit sheer in the back, so you might wanna wear a camisole with this top, if you yourself like it. I will definitely have to wear a camisole with it because, I mean, it's pretty sheer. I would wear this to work. I probably wouldn't wear this out and about, or just as an everyday top. This would definitely be a work top for me. I like the front part so much that I will end up keeping it. I love the purple. I'm just not a big floral person, and I think maybe I need to go back into my Stitch Fix like style profile and put that I'm not a huge floral person. I like some things, most of the time I don't. But that's why I'm kind of on the fence with this one, but It's not bad. It's not the worst thing. This is a size small and it retails for $44. Now that we have gone through everything, let's get to the calculations. So, for all five items, the grand total is $232. With the buy all five 25% off discount, that knocks off $58, which then brings my total down to $174. Not bad for five items. I didn't have any promotionals this month. So if you're thinking about signing up for Stitch Fix, my link is below. That would really help me a lot, please. Especially if people want me to continue with these videos. Might help. The purple one isn't my favorite top, but I do like the other five items enough for me to go ahead and just get it. And who knows, maybe I'll learn to love it. This is also fix number 32 for me. Like, whew, cannot believe that. I definitely will remember to put a note to my stylist for November's fix. It just, time got away from me. October is always a crazy time for me. I'm so sorry for looking like a train wreck today. Let me know in the comments below what item you liked the most, what item you liked the least. If you do Stitch Fix, let me know if you plan on requesting any of these items. We can be twinsies. But that is it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a big ol' thumbs up. Go on down there and hit that subscribe button wherever it may be, because I don't know, even though I do. This is just my shtick now. Also hit that notification bell in case you want to know when I upload, and in case YouTube wants to let you know when I upload, because I would really appreciate it. And until next time, bye guys.